Hi there and welcome back. It's Tanya from Tatty Treasures. Hello there. Hope everybody's doing okay. I am back to do some more Tim Holtz pieces. Now this is today's project and this is tomorrow's project, but I thought while I've got the tissue out and stuff, I might as well decoupage them both at the same time. So, hello. If you're new, then welcome aboard. If you're a returning subscriber, then it's always nice to have you back. Don't forget to say hello in the comments and give me a thumbs up. If you're not subscribed, then hit the bell so you get the notifications. You'll find all the links in the description. There's links to my Tim Holtz playlist. These pieces that I'm making are actually for a ring bound journal that I'm going to be making, but all the pieces that I've made would go, you know, into a journal or a folio or, you know, whatever. So they're also added to a ring bound journal playlist, but like I say, they'll be both in the description. There's also links to our Facebook group. We have a Facebook group called Tatty Treasures and Friends, and the moderators in there, all the links are down below, and they all have their own channels. So if you want to pop along, we have monthly challenges which all the moderators take part in, so you might want to follow those too. There's also links of ways that you can support the channel. So I've got these playing cards. I know that Laurie sent me those small ones, but I can't remember who sent me these big ones. They just sent me these two. So I was thinking that these would be ideal for another kind of page in the ring bound journal. And I was thinking, you know, I could collage on top of them, but I thought I'm going to stick some tissue on them. So I'm just inking them up because I don't know. I don't know if you'll see the edges or what. These are really quite glossy, so I don't know if the ink's going to stay on them or not, but it'll probably stay on these edges. Okay. So I've got a box of tissue at the side of me, and we'll make us mind up what we're going to use. So these are a bit smaller than the other things that I've made so far. So these are going to be like the pages. So, but yeah, I think they'll go nice with those. So if you've not caught any of these, then make sure you pop back and have a look. So I've got these two lovely ones, what Rita Jensen sent me. Rita sent me that one. So I'm just going to put the ones that are, they don't live in there. They don't live in there. I think I want that in my collage box rather than it being in here. That's a good one. This is just a brown. This is like a brown lace. Got sewing pattern. Some grey tissue. These are blues and botanicals. Got those tissues that my daughter bought me for Christmas in here. And pop those over there. They're bird ones. Oh, yes. I didn't think I'd got this one. I just saw a video on Tiffany's channel, Bluebird Creations, and she's doing a 300 giveaway. And I was saying, oh, I can't find that in the UK, this specific one, and I've already got it. I've got the bird one. they're the only two Tim Holtz ones I've got. Obviously that's more of that. That's a napkin, I'm not sure why that's in here. Then I've got little bits. I don't know if I want those in my collage or not. What's that lovely burlap that Jeannie sent me from Inky Owl Studios? I think this is a, is this a Tim Holtz? No, I don't think it is. This is totally different stuff to that. That's lovely. Oh, I've got two pieces of that. I can say somebody sent me that. I've got this decoupage paper as well from Craft Consortium, which I'm kind of leaning towards that instead of that for this project. And then the rest are sealed up, which I obviously don't want to go opening ones because I've got enough. So yeah, let's have a keep these out as well. I'd have liked to have opened this without ripping it because it could have gone in my trash Tuesday box. Still can, I can mend it, can't I? That'd be quite an interesting thing. So I'll pop that over there. Yes, I think this one's going to cover really, really nicely. So let's get a sheet. I don't know if you get three sheets in them. Yeah, three. Okay, let's just move these out of the way. Move these tiddy ones out of the way. I'm not sure if I'm going to just keep those like that because I think they go nice on there. So I'm thinking of covering the front and the back. At the back, these are going to be a belly band down it. Or I might do that at the front. And I'll probably put a pocket at the bottom, which I don't know if to get some more cards and maybe make it into a pocket like that, but we'll see how it looks once, because obviously this will be really toned down then. So how am I going to do this? I think if I keep it like that and then stick them down like so. Yes, I'll try that. So, I've got that collage medium. I'm just going to just slightly dip my brush in the water just to, I don't know, just to wet the brush. I think that was the reason. So, I'll just coat this. Seen quite a few altered card videos just lately. I think somebody's doing a challenge. I'm sure I've seen some challenge videos come on. Right, so we'll pop that down. Let's try and get it. Crease on. Oh, that's gonna look lovely. Yeah, so I'll do the other one. Maybe leaving me brush in the water wasn't a good idea. It's made it too wet. Don't want to put my brush in my lid like I used to do, because that's what then made my lid stick and I couldn't open my tub. I'm wondering if that will be okay. Can always put some over the top of it if it's not. And did that go in? I'm going to go here. And let's just make sure it's not hanging over. Okay. Going to leave that down here a bit to dry. Right, so I want to cover some of these envelopes for tomorrow's project. So I might, don't know if to cover them all with the same, or do a bit of a collage. I think with the bigger ones, I will just stick these down, and then I might do some collage with the other ones. So I have already tea stained these, and I'm probably going to spray some inks on and things when they dry. In the water. Right, let's try and just get that to the edge. Lovely. Let's do the other one and then I'll cut it off, and then I think the others I'm going to do them as a collage. I want the flaps on that way. Then the backs, I'm going to leave them tea stained because they can be used as a writing spot, I think. But if not, I can always cover them with something else when I use them tomorrow. All into the the grooves, because obviously the paper crinkles when you've tea stained it. Right, let's lay that down. You just get a wipe to wipe my hands. So I'm going to cut this off. I'll just do it a little bit wide. Just turn that over. And I'm going to cut this off now because I'm thinking I can use this in the collage. Right, I'm thinking instead of, I did have some bits and bobs, didn't I? So let's use bits and bobs up instead of starting something new. As tempting as it is, right, I want that side. Yep. No, I don't think it's going to matter. A difference, but right, I think I want to try vintage medium. Now, I don't know if to initially just stick it down with this one and then go over it with the other one, or what. I don't know. So that's... I don't think I'm going to totally cover it because I think I'll do some stamping and stuff on it. Okay, what do we think? Let me... I'm going to try it with it on. You'd have to use water, wouldn't you, to make it wetter, to make it stick down, I think. But the brush is quite damp, so... what it looks like on the white. So I'm going to try this doing it like that, but then will I be able to pick it up to place it on? No, I don't think that's the way. I like that. Right, let's have a bit of this. Perhaps go in. So I did think this would be very handy for the napkins, what I've got white and the tissue that's got white. So, do you want anything else on it? Yeah, I'm going to pop that on. Yep. Whoops-a-days. Okay, so put that down there to dry. Where's the other one? That there. So it'd be interesting to see how it dries on the tissue and on the surrounding. Like I think then I'm going to pause. I'll do the two CD ones and then we'll take a look at the card ones that I first did. Because otherwise we won't get time to do what I'm actually making. But I thought, you know, instead of coming on with these already done, ready to do the project, I thought you might want to have a look. And I know a few of you have said, asked about the vintage one, wanted to see what it looked like. So that's going that side. Okay, I will see you shortly. Okay, I'm back again. So these have dried. I've given them another coat over the top and I've just dried it off with the dryer. So I'm really happy with them. So I don't want to use the same on the other side. One, because I don't want it to look exactly the same. And obviously, you can't, I mean, you can just see the card around it. But I want it, you know, to know that it's a card. So I'm going to put this one over the top. So again, I'll paste it over, wait for it to dry off a little bit. And then I'll paste it over the top. That's the kind of way I do it. I don't know if, you know, that's the way or what. That's the way I do it. And that, you know, seems to work for me. So I'm going to do it with the vintage one. I do want my brush to be, you know, slightly wet, but I don't want it to be obviously dripping. So let me just dry that off a little bit. Okay. And then once the, you know, both sides are dry, I'll trim it all off and then give it a good ink around the edges. Even though this other side's dry, it is still a little bit tacky. So we'll have to pause again and yeah, come back when it's dry. I've given the other things, the envelopes, a second coat as well, so they'll be ready for tomorrow's video. But I just thought I'll use my noggin and do both at the same time because it will save me having to clean my brush twice and get my mat out. And yeah, it just makes sense, doesn't it? I think it's probably, you know, if I could have thought of other things that I wanted in the future, like next week, I don't mean, you know, 6 months time, but yeah, I think, you know, doing quite a few things at the same time, I don't think it matters what side it is. Would obviously be more time effective. And I think then you're in the mood, aren't you, kind of thing. Might not be in the mood now, this is all crumpled, but but yeah, I think it's easier to get in the mood. Right, I'm just gonna cut this off and try and get some of those wrinkles out. Move that over there. I'll do it with a brush, I think. Mind you. Yeah, that's it. I can say I do like a certain amount of wrinkles in there, but I want them to be flat wrinkles, not you know, full of air wrinkles. So yeah, that's gonna be a lot better over the top. Just dulls it down, but we can still see that it's a playing card. So this probably won't want another coat now. This is probably enough, which is good. Be quicker to dry. So I'm just going to pop that, I was going to say downstairs, on the floor at the side of me. Right. Oh, I have to keep remembering not to wheel round on my chair because I've got all wet things at the back of me. Did used to be able to put things on my trolley at the side of me, and I've got two little sets of drawers, but they're all full because yeah, well, we're at the beginning of the year. I've brought lots of things, you know, for future projects and things, I've still got kits from last year, what I wanted to, you know, use and things. So, yeah, I've got quite a lot of, you know, folders set up and all things gathered. And hopefully in a few months, I'll have a little bit more room. I don't know why I'm struggling with this one. Gosh, it's because I'm just chatting. Just chatting. So I was just thinking about all my piles laying about, but yeah, hopefully another couple of months there'll be I'll end up with some more room, because I think apart from, you know, a matching ribbon to go with things and stuff like that, I'm pretty well set now. I mean, that's probably far too organized for a lot of people, and I totally get that, but yeah, I kind of like to know what I'm doing, when I'm doing it, and all the rest of it. And you know, I've certain papers and things that I'm really keen on, you know, definitely using. I mean, I bought the Stamperia probably a year ago, and I've still not used it. I mean, the main thing is with that is I'm not sure how to use it. I'm getting a bit more, I think it's a confidence thing, isn't it? I mean, they're pretty hard papers to use, I think, to the best, you know, because you don't get that many pages and stuff. So, yeah, I've got, you know, lots of different things that I want to get definitely done this year, because apart from Tim Holtz pads, I'm not buying, you know, any more pads until I've done certain projects. So if I don't kind of get them out and think, well, you know, what backing card am I going to use with it, what materials am I going to use with it, how am I going to embellish it, and start gathering those things, I'll never do it, because every time I'll get it out, I'll think, oh, I don't know what I'm going to do with it. So, yeah, I'm kind of surrounded by things at the moment, which, yeah, makes me feel quite claustrophobic, because I can't, you know, move about and stuff as I'd like to. So hopefully that will be the last part of having to stick those down. I think they'll all be fine, and I'm not covering the little cards. Like I say, these are really old, and they you know, got that aged look anyway. I'll probably decorate them up with some Tim Holtz ephemera. So that's that. So I think for now I'm gonna go and put my brush in soak, and we'll just leave those to dry, and I will come back and yeah, we'll get this pocket made. So see you soon. Okay, I'm back, they're dry. So I re-inked them round, and I've just had some of this rusty hinge. So I just put a small amount, because I've never used it before. So I was a little bit, oh, is it gonna be too orangey? Goes really well. That I did that with the walnut stain. I'm guessing this vintage photo would look superb, because they both got that orangey kind of look. And then I just dropped some spots of the vintage photo on, and I dropped a few of the cosmic shimmer, and this is in ancient copper. So that's what I did. They're all dry. So I'm going to put these on the back, because they look better on this than they do on there. So these are going to go on the back. So I'm thinking, let me check it's the right way, that I can do four. You know, like that. Does it need to be? Yeah. So if I get the, I'm thinking Fabri-Tac, just for the fact of it will dry quicker. Ooh. So if I stick the cards together, I don't know how good this will be at, you know, actually getting things in there. So, you know, behind it. So if that one's there, then that one there. Like so. Yep. Slidey, slidey. Let's just pick that up. Yeah, that's better. So I like that. And then this one like that. Yeah, I like that. So I put a dot there. That there, so I'll give that a minute to all stick together. So do the same with this. So we'll go like that, dab about in the middle, go that way, dab about in the middle, yeah. And top in the middle, like so. That fit, yeah. Okay, let's stick this down then. Oh, it's still a little bit wet. So I'm going to glue it, I think, round there, and then round there. Just push that a bit. That's that middle. Yeah, that's middle-ish. Okay, so we'll leave that to dry a minute. I do like that. And like I say, I'll decorate it with some Tim Holtz things. So after tomorrow, oh dear, after tomorrow's video, this definitely hasn't dried, has it? Let's stick that down. I'll tell you in a minute. Let's not talk. Yeah, after tomorrow's video, I think that's the last piece of ephemera I'm gonna make. So while we're waiting for those two, so we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and that's what I wanted, because I want three sets of three in between each signature. We'll have a session or two on revisiting all the pieces and getting them embellished, because some things I have embellished and some things I haven't. So we'll do an embellishment. And then I'll need to make the side bits that I need sticking on with the eyelets in, which will, you know, go attached to the rings. And then we'll have the cover to make. And then that'll be it. Oh, the journals, three journals. So we'll need a video on that. So I might try and get the embellishments in just one video. So let's turn that round there. And I've got some scraps left from the die cuts with a view pad. And I'm thinking we'll make a pocket at the bottom and put a playing card on. Not liking the yellow at all with these. Not liking that. I think it needs to be the brown. I'll go for that one. Okay, okay. So, how much have we got each side? Let's measure the pocket, the card. So it's 12 centimeters. So it's 4 and 3/4. I want the scoreboard. 4¾. I'm going to do a half inch there, and then if we go to 4¾, then I'll just have to cut a bit off. Let's have a look at that. Yeah, that's super. And then I'll do half an inch down the bottom. Yeah, do the same with this one. So half, fold that down, 4¾ there, and then we want, I've got glue on my fingers, dried glue, half there. So that's that. Okay, let's get the scissors and we're going to cut down that, and I'm going to cut around that, and here, and here. Shall, you know, get the bone folder and squash it down. So I can't see the crease on this one. That. That's I want to ink around it because it has got a white core. I'm thinking, do I want some cheesecloth or do? Oh, I might do it on a tea bag actually. Do a bit of a collage like behind it. So that's that. The cards have been inked. So that's that. Let's get the lid on this a minute. I'll keep it out in case I end up putting fabric on. I've sat today and cleaned all my scissors and filled all my glues up. So that was a good job, wasn't it? Ooh, oh dear. Oh no. I think I need to get some collaging done. Oh, everything's just absolutely fell out. Right, let's this might be nice. So yeah, maybe something like that behind. That's nice. I think I probably have to put a bit of this brown paper on. So if I do that like so. Yeah, that would be nice. I don't want grey. Do I want a bit of tea bag as well? I don't know. Let's open it up and we'll have a look. Let's just take the perforation bit off. Might want that pushed in somewhere, and that for that. Right, so that's that. I need to tidy this box. I think if it was tidied better, it wouldn't fall out. But yeah, I'm getting ready for getting some collage boards done and things. Because I've got quite a few scraps building up. Right, that's get these nicely placed. I don't need that glue. Let's just use the Anita's Tacky Glue. Now this might need a pin through it, but we'll see. Oh, it's okay. Okay, that was a bit much, but it's better than it not coming out. So if we have that like so, and then let's just rip this down a little bit. More parts of that coming out like that. Lovely. So we'll put that on the card. That's it. Get that in the corner. Move that up. That's that. Yeah, I like that. Let's get that stuck on. I'm not going to put any on there. I want it, you know, to be flowy. Is that about in the middle? Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I like that. I think I'm going to have to round the bottom of that. It's like so. Spot on width wise. I could have done with doing it just a little bit slimmer. Just yeah, that's super. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, might as well do this now. Okay. Right, so we've got this big piece, haven't we? Yep. Yeah. So we'll go around here, get that on. If I'm not off screen, I have put the camera quite close because I knew, you know, we was just doing one thing. Seem to go a bit closer. That's lovely. I feel like I've been on all day. I mean, I have, because obviously I've had to wait for things to dry and stuff. So all I've been really doing is faffing about on the computer. It's like the whole day is gone, and you know, I've only done one video. Only made, you know, two things, and yeah, I've prepped for tomorrow's video, but yeah, I just feel like I've you know, where's my day gone? Right, let's get these glued down. I'm really happy with these. The only thing I am thinking is when I do come to put the extending bit on, what will have the grommets in, it's like, are they going to get in the way? Because obviously this pocket goes right to the edge. And, you know, I need to attach a hinge. But I'm sure it'll be fine. You know, I'm only going to take that much. It might make things look a little bit off-centre. But I think that'll work out fine. But I know when I did it last time and I was just doing an individual piece, then putting that bit on, and putting the grommets in and that, it sent odd work. So I'm thinking this time we're doing the pieces first and then doing all the sides all in one go. I'll probably be able to, you know, streamline it a little bit. But I'd only just add my crocodile when I did the last one. I mean, I'm no, you know, I'm still a bit nervy with it, but yeah, more confident than I first was. I think I literally used it for the first time on that ring band. I think that was the reason why I ended up thinking, yeah, I'm gonna buy a crocodile, because obviously I'd you know, thought about it for quite a while, and then it was like, oh, I've got Project Rock, you know, I do really need one, so I best have one. So yeah, I'm sure it'll work out. So yeah, I like those. Again, it's gonna, you know, want an embellishment and what have you. So that is those. I'm gonna leave the video at that now because obviously I've paused it quite a few times and I need to join them on, and I've lost track of, you know, how long I was on each time. So I'm thinking this video is probably 40-50 minutes long. But yeah, we've got those done and obviously we're prepped for tomorrow. So thank you very much for joining me. I hope you enjoyed that. And I will see you tomorrow. Bye for now.